Hi, in this video, I'll show you how we can provide or arrange street absurd tiles in different sizes of columns. In the practical civil engineering field, it is very much essential to provide street abs with the help of suitable drawings for a structural erection purpose. So, I think you will learn something new today. So, let's start the topic. Hi, my name is Suman and I make videos on civil engineering practical knowledge and you are watching your channel Civil Unboxing. At very first, as you already know, the column is designed and placed with longitudinal reinforcement and transverse reinforcement. So the transverse reinforcement is technically known to be as lateral ties or stirrups. Stirrups are mainly provided for counteracting the buckling effect of column due to loading conditions. So, let's consider some different sizes of columns with various numbers of bars according to shape and sizes, and we will learn the concept of stirrup shapes or arrangement of stirrups. So, alright, in the first picture, we can see that there is a column with having the cross-sectional size less than 100 mm by 100 mm. Which is having four numbers of longitudinal bars at corners. So in this type of structure, we can use only single regular size of stirrup only. So now in the second type of column, we can see that column is less than 150 mm by 150 mm, which is having six numbers of longitudinal bars, out of which four numbers of longitudinal bars is having in the corner side and fifth and sixth number of bars are in the inner side of the column. Here also we can provide one regular size of stirrup or lateral ties only. Now in the third type of column, we can see that the column is greater than cross sectional size of having more than 150 mm by 150 mm size with six numbers of longitudinal bars. So here also we can provide one regular size of stirrup or tie at the corner bars which is provided in the column and one link which is connected to the longitudinal bar number 5th and 6th. Or otherwise we can provide also first four numbers of bars with a connection of single tie and last four numbers of bars with a connection of another single tie. So now in the fourth type of column, we can see that the column is of more than 150 mm in lengthwise but less than 150 mm in widthwise, which is having 8 numbers of longitudinal bars. So here we can also just provide two regular size of stirrups only. As in the picture, you can clearly see that the bar number 15647 is connected with one regular size of stirrup. And remaining other bars like 5, 2, 8, 3, 6, these bars are connected with another regular size of stirrups. For this size of column, we can provide two regular size of stirrups or ties only. Now coming to the fifth type of column, as we can see that column is having more than 150 mm by 150 mm in cross-sectional dimension with consisting of 8 numbers of longitudinal bars. So here also we can provide the corner bars with a regular size of stirrups. So as in the picture, we can see that the number of bars with having 1, 2, 3, 4 marking, those bars are connected with one regular size of stirrups, as well as bar number 5 and 6 is connected with a regular size of link, and 7th and 8th number of bars is connected also with a regular size of links. So here in that type of cross-sectional column, we can provide just one regular size of ties and two links only. Coming to the sixth type of column, we can see that the column size is more than 150 mm by 150 mm which is also having eight numbers of longitudinal bars. In the cross section of the column, we can provide one link at the corner bars, like 1, 2, 3, 4 numbers of bars can be connected with one regular size of ties or stirrup, and another tie can be connected with 5, 7, 6, 8 numbers of longitudinal bars. So now coming to the seventh type of column, we can see that the column size is having more than 225 mm but less than 150 mm in widthwise. So here we are providing 10 numbers of longitudinal bars. So while providing the stirrups in the column, we have to use two regular size of stirrups which is rectangular like shape. So as you can see, the bar numbers 1, 5th, 6th, 2nd, 10th and 9th numbers of bars can be connected with a rectangular size stirrup. Whereas similarly, bar number 9, 10, 3, 8, 7, 4th is connected with another rectangular size stirrup. So remaining bars like innermost bar like 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th bars is connected with a regular size of stirrup. So this is the main concern regarding providing or arrangement of stirrups in the type of column. Now coming to the last and 8th type of column, we can see that the column size is more than 225 and 150 mm which is widthwise, with also having 10 numbers of longitudinal bars. So in this type of column we can provide two regular size of stirrups and one hexagonal type of stirrup which is clearly shown in the picture below. As you can see, bar number 1st, 5th, 6th, 8th, 7th, 4th and 9th is connected with one regular size of stirrup, whereas similarly bar number 5th, 6th, 2nd, 10th, 3rd, 8th and 7th number is connected with another regular size of stirrup. Whereas as the dimension of the cross sectional size of column is more than 225 lengthwise and more than 150 mm in widthwise, we have to provide a hexagonal type of stirrup which is regularly connected with 5th, 6th, 10th, 8th, 7th and 9th. So here we can provide just two regular size of stirrup and one hexagonal type of stirrup. So as you observe in this, the column having three different types of stirrups, which is quite difficult to provide the correct stirrups as per a structural drawing. My motive is to provide a deep knowledge about the stirrup placing or structural arrangement for stirrups at suitable place according to design. As you know, this is very much important fact for executing any column erecting works. So I hope you got a little concept clearly. If you think that you have learned something from this topic, then please poll your opinion on the comment box. Do like, share and subscribe to my channel so that you get more informative civil unboxing video in the upcoming classes. That's it for today. Thanks for being with me. Thanks a lot.